Namaste and welcome to Geeta's Kitchen. Today in our South Indian veg meal side dishes, let's make Milagu Kozhambu. Milagu Kozhambu is again a side dish made with tamarind juice and some other spices and curry leaves, and with no addition of dal in it, and it is served along with some hot rice. So let us see how we go about making it. First, we have to fry some ingredients, and it's always better to use sesame oil or till oil, gingerly oil, for making the Milagu Kozhambu. It imparts a very good taste. Milagu Kozhambu and vatta kozhambu, use till oil or gingerly oil if you can. The ingredients you require are one large lemon sized ball of tamarind. I have extracted the juice. Then you will need 1 teaspoon of black pepper, 1 teaspoon of jeera, 2 red chilies, and 1 tablespoon of urad dal, a large handful of curry leaves, salt, asafoetida, and some oil. This Milagu Kozhambu, in some households, they just increase the quantity of curry leaves, and it is also called as karuvappila kozhambu. So you can see how it is made. First, heat a tablespoon of oil in the pan, and when the oil is hot, add 1 teaspoon of pepper, 1 teaspoon of jeera or cumin seeds, and 1 teaspoon of urad dal or black gram dal, and 2 dry red chilies. Allow these to fry well till the urad dal becomes red in color. Switch off the gas and add your washed curry leaves to this. Allow this to cool. When it is cool, we will grind it into a paste in the mixer. Meanwhile, heat a thick pan. Again, add a tablespoon of sesame oil or till oil, and then add a teaspoon of mustard seeds and wait for it to splutter. Now it has splutter. Add a generous pinch of asafoetida, and then pour in the tamarind juice into it. Add about 2 teaspoons of salt and allow it to boil. When it has boiled for about 5 minutes, then we can add the ground paste to it. See, now it is coming to a boil, and your paste is also ready, the curry leaves and spices paste. You can add this to the tamarind juice. Now allow it to again boil well for about 10 minutes till it thickens and becomes a little bit concentrated. Then we'll come back and have a look at it. See, now it has been boiling for about 15 minutes. It has reduced well in quantity, and see how it has thickened. At this stage, you can switch it off and transfer it to the vessel in which you want to serve. The tasty Milagu Kozhambu is ready to be eaten with hot rice, and add a teaspoon of gingery oil or till oil to it, and it tastes out of the world. So please keep watching Geeta's Kitchen and subscribe to my channel. Thank you.